Hello, welcome back. Welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. I'm the RPG Chick. We are fighting our way out of Blood Sands after completing, well, half of Berath's quest and killing this guy who's, I guess, using the sacrifices to stay alive forever, or at the very least...
Nice and quiet.
Indefinitely? We killed all these people. I don't think we have to sneak up here. We're kind of overdoing ourselves. Not exactly sneaking out. We're kind of sneaking around and killing everyone we see along the way. Why not wipe them out? Alright, we've seen that. So we're gonna head through this. So we've pretty much, yeah, there's someone over there. We started here, moved our way around, killed everyone there, killed people around here and up there, and in here, and then camped there. So, and pretty much that's where we started the episode off. So we're gonna make our way up. I think we can go through a little narrow passageway there, and we'll make our way through here, 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 and then through the main chamber, which is gonna be some huge freaking battle, and then out. And then we have to head to Elmshore to meet the other... this woman? I don't know. I don't remember who she is. To complete the other half of the quest. Kill that, kill him, and then kill her. So... Okay, we actually didn't attack or anything. Durance in front, okay. Let's see if Palagina can make our way through. And Adair. It's right here. Might as well hit him.
Yes?
Whoa! Well, that was easy. I think that's courtesy... The flames are courtesy of, Kanna.
Hmm?
Yeah?
I shall be quiet as a calm sea. Which is... not very quiet.
Who stopped seeing us? We had yellow for a sec. Yeah, we could go through there. So we'll come across some more pretty soon. Soonish. He's just striding along, doing his little chanter stuff. And he's gonna get an arrow in the face. Maybe some bullets or rounds or whatever you call them. Awesome. These guys are so weak, I'm just using his... I don't want to waste his big spells.
Hit.
You guys stuck behind... They're... Kanna! Oh my god. They already killed him. You guys missed out on the fun. We get past each other. All right.
Let's see what lies this way.
How about all of us do?
Got it.
All right, so... Yeah, let's go up here and then make our way down. It's just the one? Oh, nope, there's a bunch.
Gotcha.
Nice.
Following your lead.
Lava. We play with them too hard. They break too easily.
Offer further.
That thing's gotta be courtesy of Canna. That never happened before. I'll take a look. And this, whatever's going on here.
Following your lead.
It's gotta be that hazard field causing burn and slash. And then that trail of frost, and then frightening them. An opal and 466 copper.
As you say.
Yeah.
As you say. Not sure if I've heard him say that before.
Nice and quiet.
Yeah, we'll go up here. Too easy.
I shall be quiet as a calm sea, which is not very quiet.
Svef. How tough is this guy gonna be? Erona's head turns to you, but she seems to look past you through cloudy eyes. I have heard the screams of the others and smelled their blood in the air. A grim irony that the ethnic gnolls should perish alongside a millennium of sacrifices. The ancient dwarf inhales deeply. You're doing. Come to finish an old blind woman too? Or have you other business? Well, then we can take this, I guess.
Laying low.
She is blind. How can she see us? As she smells us, or hears us, or something, or both. Alright, we're making good time. We're gonna come up around here to the main attraction. Keeper. So we still have, yeah, ranged weapons.
Following your lead.
This is gonna be a long battle.
Lava.
Hmm. Kind of knocked down two of them. This is kind of a waste. These guys aren't high level at all. Can I use that instead? Thank you. Keeper Garast. Oh, that was really easy. Seriously? I mean, there might be some more people down here, but that's it? I had a much harder time at Noonfrost.
Sure.
Much harder time at Noonfrost. It's all these years of sacrificing and comfortable living have made them soft. Talon's amulet. Why are we automatically comparing now? This amulet consists of an engraved circular disc carved from bone and hanging from a simple leather cord. Plus 9 will. That's pretty good. Oh, I didn't hit shift, did I? The opal? Oh, it did go in storage? Or whatever they call that? Stash? The other ST word? Stash! The other ST word.
Eyes open.
Yeah, so you don't run into things. Now, the passage to... And we've been there, okay. Well, that was surprisingly easy. And that's it. They're gonna fight us when we come out, too? The supplicants? These guys have no idea what happened. Well, your whole tribe... Well, not the tribe, but... Those who would have helped you die for your tribe are now gone. Alright, so for the Golden Grove... What's her name? Excuse me. Is in Elmshore, so... All we need to do is head to any exit. We go to Elmshore, and that'll be stage 2 of our quest for Berath, actually. Just in case.
Let's see what lies this way.
This way lies Elmshore. I remember this zone being quite difficult. We had really huge battles. Things kept coming in, you know, joining the fight before we were done, and yeah, it was pretty tough battles. Okay, so where are we looking? I guess we're... Probably either by the two arches. I can't see her being in the cave. I mean, that's where ogres were. There's nothing special in there. Let's see if it says anything here. The druids of the Golden Grove told me the High Ovi Erona often ventures to Elmshore in search of remedies to prolong her life. I suspect that Erona is the elven woman from the vision. So... I can't see sneaking through all of here. Let's go to the bridge and then... So I'm thinking we're going to speak to her first anyway, and we've cleared everything out of here. Let's just go to these arches. We have some companions quests to take care of in this area as well. Okay, well here's one arch. Unless she's standing on the other side of it where we can't see, then she's not there. There's plenty of healing stuff here. I missed that one. Look at that. One of the birds we need! Awesome! This guy in Old Song was looking for these. He's gonna eat them so he can sing better. Is that insane or what? I think we're supposed to get three. Here's one of them. Interlocked and concave, the iridescent green feathers of this bird resemble crystalline scales. When startled, it completely freezes on the spot, only to resume its slow singing once it feels safe again. Dilem. Or Dilam, however you say it. Wow, we found that one. This we'll probably find when we venture to fight that dragon. And this is kept in cages? Was there one? Was there one in that inn? Up in the tree? In, what do you call it? I can't think of any names. In Hearthsong. Can't remember the name of the. What do you call it? The place. There might be a bird there. Alright, where is this lady? Ah! Nope, that's an antelope. Where am I supposed to be looking for her? Not in the cave, right? It doesn't seem like the kind of place she'd go. Elder Stag. Yeah, maybe on one of these aisles. One of the aisles had completely nothing on it. Look over this way really quick. It'd be stupid to, like, if she's standing over here and to pass it by. Alright. Let's cross that. Hold on a second, guys. Whoop. Okay. Itchy on ear. Where are you, lady? The only thing I can think is she's in the center here and we overlooked her. Or she's on this island. Or she's in the cave. That's all that's really left. That's awesome, we found that bird. It would make sense if she was on this island. We didn't find anything here. Nothing of note. He keeps seeing movement. I'm like, there she is. Nope. Not a human being. Are you kidding? So it ends here. She's up by the crossroads, or she's in the cave. Or she's not there at all. And the game is trolling me. And you! For watching me go through this crap. Crossroads, right? Watch her be in that damn cave. I don't know where else she could be.
Shh.
Don't you shush me. No, there's completely nobody here. Huh. What?
What?
Yeah, exactly. That's what I was saying.
Sure. Where is this lady? She's annoying me now. She hasn't taken the form of a stag, has she?
She's not under there, is she? No. There's a lot of ingredients, bushes, and things around these bridges. But I don't see her there. And I keep hitting tab to highlight her in case if she's hard to see for some reason. I've looked here. Oh, wait. We haven't gone here. Okay. So I feel like sneaking.
I shall be discreet.
Sneaking now. She's gotta be here. This was another place where we didn't find anything at all. Ovate's guard. Okay! She's just kinda drifting forward. An elf stands on a dais in the middle of a clearing. The ground is blanketed with leaves in various shades of russet and gold. Her eyes are closed and her arms folded in front of her. A curtain of autumnal yellow hair hangs in front of her face. As you draw near, she lifts her chin and looks at you with shifting hazel eyes.
Greetings, Estramor. You are among the Ovates of the Golden Grove.
They brighten from dull brown to vivid green. Her voice is as soft as a breeze sighing through trees. These people were not here before, of course. And you are? Like Hermione in the first Harry Potter movie.
High Ovate, an ancient elm among poles and saplings. We have taken root in the same soil, and the others grow in my shade. Their roots nourish my soil. My branches give them shelter. Together, we grow.
Her eyes pulse with a deep, summery green. Your essence churns like an eddy in the stream, Estramor. Speak the questions on your mind. Speak plainly, will you? I'd like to know more about the Ovates of the Golden Grove.
Like the leaves of a tree, we are many sharing one source, one purpose. Living or dying, we nourish one another. The truths of the soul and of the body are written on every blade of grass and sung by every creature under the sun. We learn these truths and sing them back.
Ours is not the song of the gods, but of Aretha. This is why many of our number study the discourse of herbs and inhabit the skins of beasts. You're druids? Are you familiar with the Ethic Knoll? A wrinkle of distaste curls her lip. A swarm of maggots on a dead songbird. Worms hollowing a mighty spruce. They celebrate the withering life of life rather than its bidding. They seize strength from others instead of accepting what Aretha freely gives. Her eyes dim to a blackish brown. They take pride in their independence from the gods, yet their leaders demand an even greater sacrifice. Death for life. Strength from the spent essence of their petitioners. The Ethic Knoll offer another kind of servitude, and one to Kith whose souls have long since rotted. The Ethic Knoll should save lives, not end them. Flecks of green open like buds in her eyes. On this, we agree. Not sure why I'm saying this. Speak plainly, will you? She gives you a mischievous half-grin, while her eyes fade to gray. The words on my tongue are the language of a stream cleaving stones and the wind guiding seeds. If you do not understand, it is because the tongues of Kith have deafened you. Well, Berath has sent me to end your life. It has continued for too long.
You once railed against mighty and distant powers, did you not? What is a god that his voice should carry so far? And what are you that you should so eagerly obey? The gods only have dominion over what we seed, and you would seed matters of life and death to them.
Her mirthless laughter sounds like water breaking on rocks. I didn't hear any laughter. Adair says, "It's that or trust your neighbors. If you had my neighbors, you might think twice about that." "But are you any different? You've extended your life beyond its natural span." "Through work and wisdom. The greater the tree, the more fruit it may yield." She nods at the ovates gathered in the clearing. "They are vines claiming an ancient elm into the sunlight. My growth sustains them. Should our harmony fall prey to a god's jealousy?" Palagina says, "We should not be slaves to the whims of the gods, but I find it hard to see what her followers gain from this arrangement." "The gods are wiser and more ancient even than you. It is not for either of us to oppose them." She shakes her head. "It is a shame we could not come to an accord." "A shame for you, maybe." Combat start. Holy Radiance. Right, I forgot to... How about we try Slick, which is like a grease spell. Death to Ming! Slick, knock you down. That's the high ovate. Awesome. Well, you can stop trying to do that now. Palagina soloing everybody. Try this rolling flame. Oh, it can't. It's gonna hit Adair. Or Palagina, rather. Alright, what else we got? Ghost blades? Faux AoE. Mostly just want to see the effect of this. I'm still gonna even hit anybody. He has to move forward. Alright, now try it. Well, he's basically dead. He's still knocked down from the grease. That's pretty awesome. Whatever it's called. Slickin'. It's not grease, it's slickin'.
Yes.
I think that's D&D. It's called grease. So what the hell happened there? It's not like someone just took a swing at us. Ring of Protection. A Ripple Sponge. Potion of Fleet Feet. An Emerald. Have you ever seen an Emerald? A highly rare stone. Wow, 750 copper. Emeralds are usually thought of as green, but in some cases can be completely colorless. The discovery of an emerald deposit generally means a lifetime of prosperity for its discoverer. Nice. Okay, so nothing special, she just had that emerald. Unless you consider exceptional and fine stuff special, which in their own way they are. Ovate. Mrs. Durant spreading plague. They're dead. Okay. From the grave, they attack us still. Okay, people. Thanks for watching. See you next time. We go to speak to... who's it again? Berath. So, yeah, just a second. I'm not signing off just now yet then. The only thing we have to do after that is for Helia to go up and, the merchant stalls is done. For the third time. Now we really need protection. And it sucks our library is gone. Good thing if you store something, I guess it's gone forever. Build our curtain wall up again. So, yeah, Helia's next after this, but first we're going to go back and, you know, complete the quest, go back to Tyr Evron and talk to Berath himself and one or two other deities who choose to come along. I'm actually really impressed by that, guys. I haven't really said so. You know, because I mostly just experience things and let you guys experience with me, and I don't comment that much. But maybe I should comment more. But the graphics in my mind from these gods talking to us is better than it just about any game I could think of. You know, because it actually was in my mind, and when we went to go talk to Remergand and... He didn't come along. He didn't actually speak with us, just a brief sentence, and that's it. I'm like, wow, you know, the graphics from when we talked to, what's his name? The first god. Galloween. I'm like, the graphics from that were excellent, and I stopped for a second, I'm like, there were no graphics. It was all just explained. So the graphics are in my head. So just goes to tell you guys, reading is fundamental. So thanks for watching. See you next time. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.